YouTube, and I'm really excited to continue with the Romeo and Juliet play. Juliet's bedroom. Capulet enters to find his daughter in tears, but explodes with anger when he is told that she has refused to marry Paris. I wonder at this haste that I must wed ere he that should be my husband comes to woo. I pray you tell my lord and father, madame, I will not marry yet, and when I do, I swear it shall be Romeo, whom you know I hate, rather than Paris. These are news indeed. Lady Capulet, here comes your father, tell him so yourself, and see how he will take it at your hands. Enter Capulet and nurse. Capulet, when the sun sets, the earth doth drizzle dew, but for the sunset of my brother's son, it rains downright. How now, a conduit girl, what still in tears, evermore showering in one little body, thou counterfeits a bark, a sea, a wind. For still thy eyes, which I may call the sea, do ebb and flow with tears. The bark thy body is, sailing in this salt food, the winds thy sights, who raging with thy tears, and they with them, without a sudden calm, will overset thy tempest-tossed body. How now, wife, have you delivered to her our degree? Sorry about that. Lady Capulet. I, sir, but she will none. She gives you thanks. I will, would the fool were married to her grave. Capulet. Soft, take me with you, take me with you, wife. How will she none? Doth she not give us thanks? Is she not proud? Doth she not count her blood blessed? And worthy as she is that we have wrought, so worthy a gentleman to be her bride. Juliet, not proud you have, but thankful that you have proud. Can I never be of what I hate, but thankful even for hate that is meant love? Capulet. How, chop logic, what is this, proud, and I thank you, and I thank you not, and yet not proud, mistress, minion, you thank me, no thankings, not proud, me no prouds, but fettle your fine joints against the Thursday next. Capulet, maddened with rage at his daughter's disobedience, threatens and insults her. He ignores the attempts of his wife and the nurse to calm him down. To go with Paris to St. Peter's Church, or I will drag thee on a hurdle thither. Out, you green sickness carrion, out, you baggage, you tallow face. Lady Capulet, to her husband, fie, fie, what are you, mad? Juliet, good father, I beseech you on my knees, hear me with patience, but to speak a word. Capulet, hang there, young baggage, disobedient wretch, I tell thee what, get thee to church, O Thursday, O never after looking me in the face. Speak not, reply not, do not answer me, my fingers itch, wife, we scarce thought us blessed, that God had lent us but this only child, but now I see this one is one too much, and that we have a curse in having her out on her hilding. Nurse, God in heaven bless her, you are to blame, my lord, to rate her so. Capulet, and why, my lady wisdom, hold your tongue, good prudence, matter with your gossips, go. Nurse, I speak no treason. Capulet, O God, ye gooden. Nurse, may not one speak. Capulet, peace your mumbling fool, utter your gravity o'er a gossip's bold, for her we need it not. Lady Capulet, you are too hot. Capulet, God spread, it makes me mad. Day, night, hour, tide, time, work, a play, alone in company, still my care hath been to have her matched, and having now provided a gentleman of no noble percentage. I'm just going to do a bit of tapping. My long nails now. Hope you like them. Okay. Capulet storms out, threatening to throw Juliet out of the house unless she agrees to marry Paris. When her mother rejects her too, Juliet turns to the nurse for comfort and advice. Offered Dimesnes, youthful and nobly trained, stuffed, as they say, with honourable parts, proportioned as one's thought would wish a man, and then to have a wretched pulling fool, a whining mammet in her fortunes tender. To answer, I'll not wed, I cannot love, I'm too young, I pray you pardon me, but, and you will not wed, I'll pardon you. Graze where you will, you shall not house with me. Look to think on, I do not use to jest. Thursday is near. Lay hand on heart, advise, and you be mine. I'll give you to my friend, and you be not. Hang, beg, starve, die in the streets. For, by my soul, I'll never acknowledge thee, nor what is mine shall never do thee good. Trust to it, we think you, I'll not be forsworn. Exit Capulet. Juliet. Is there no pity sitting in the clouds that sees into the bottom of my grief? Oh, sweet my mother, cast me not away. Delay this marriage for a month, a week, or if you do not, make the bridal bed in that dim monument where Tybalt lies. Lady Capulet, talk not to me, for I'll not speak a word. Do as thou wilt, for I have done with thee. Exit Lady Capulet. Juliet, O God, O nurse, how shall this be prevented? My husband is on earth, my faith in heaven. How shall that faith return again to earth? Unless that husband send it to me from heaven by leaving earth, comfort me, console me. Alack, alack, that heaven should practice strangems upon so soft a subject as myself. What sayest thou? Hast thou not a word of joy? Some comfort, nurse. Nurse, faith, here it is. Romeo is banished, and all the world to nothing. World to nothing, that he dares ne'er come back to challenge you. The nurse advises Juliet to marry Paris. Since Romeo will never be able to claim her as his wife, Juliet is appalled, but hides her feelings and instructs the nurse to say that she has gone to Friar Lawrence's cell, sorry that she has displeased her father. In reality, she goes to seek help. Or if he do, it needs must be by stealth. Then, since the case so stands as now it doth, I think it best you married with the county. Oh, he's a lovely gentleman. Romeo's a dish clout to him. An eagle, madam, hath not so green, so quick, so fair an eye as Paris hath beshrew my very heart. I think you are happy in this second match, for it excels your first. Or if it did not, your first is dead, or were as good he were as living here, and you no use of him. Juliet, speakest thou from thy heart? Nurse, and from my soul too, else beshrew them both. Juliet, amen. Nurse, what? Juliet, well, thou hast comforted me marvellous much. Go in and tell my lady I am gone, having displeased my father, to Lawrence's cell to make confession and to be absolved. Nurse, marry I will, and this is wisely done. Exit nurse. Juliet, ancient damnation, O most wicked friend, fiend, as it is more sin to wish me thus forsworn, or to dispraise my lord with that same tongue which he hath praised him with above compare so many thousand times. Go, counsellor, thou and my bosom henceforth shall be twain. I'll to the friar to know his remedy. If all else fail, myself have power to die. Exit Juliet. Okay, this is just the exam practice part for those that are studying this in school. So I'll just keep it up for you for a few seconds. And you may pause if you like and just kind of go over these questions. See that one clearly. Okay. Okay, starting on Friar Lawrence, Act 4, Scene 1. Julie arrives at Friar Lawrence's cell just as Paris is discussing arrangements for their wedding. Friar Lawrence's cell. into Friar Lawrence in Paris. Friar Lawrence, on Thursday, sir, the time is very short. Paris, my father Capulet will have it so, and I am nothing slow to slack his haste. Friar Lawrence, you say you do not know the lady's mind. Uneven is the course, I like it not. Paris, immoderately she weeps for Tybalt's death, and therefore have I little talked of love. For Venus smiles not in a house of tears. Now, sir, her father counts it dangerous that she do give her sorrow so much sway, and in his wisdom hastes our marriage to stop the inundation of her tears, which too much minded by herself alone may be put from her by society. Now do you know the reason of this haste? Friar Lawrence aside, I knew not why it should be slowed. Look, sir, here comes the lady toward myself. Enter Juliet. Paris, happily met, my lady and my wife. Juliet, that may be, sir, when I may be a wife. Paris, that may be, must be love on Thursday next. Juliet, what must be shall be. Friar Lawrence, that's a certain text. Paris, come you to make confession to this father? Juliet, to answer that, I should confess to you. Juliet responds coldly and ambiguously to Paris's words of love, and as soon as he is gone, begs the friar's help. Paris, do not deny to him that you love me. Juliet, I will confess to you that I love him. Paris, so will ye, I am sure, that you love me. Juliet, if I do so, it will be of more price being spoke behind your back than to your face. Paris, poor soul, thy face is much abused with tears. Juliet, the tears have got small victory by that, for it was bad enough before their spite. Paris, thou wrongest it more than tears with that report. Juliet, that is no slander, sir, which is a truth, and what I speak it to my face. Paris, thy face is mine, and thou hast slandered it. Juliet, it may be so, for it is not mine own. Are you at leisure, holy father? Now, or shall I come to you at evening mass? Friar Lawrence, my leisure serves me, pensive daughter. Now, my lord, we must entreat the time alone. Paris, God shield I should disturb devotion. Juliet, on Thursday early will I rouse ye. Till then, adieu, and keep this holy kiss. He kisses her and leaves. Juliet, oh, shut the door, and when thou hast done so, come weep with me, past hope, past care, past help. Friar Lawrence, oh, Juliet, I already know thy grief. It strains me past the compass of my wits. I hear thou must, and nothing may prorogue it. On Thursday next be married to this country, county. Juliet, tell me not, Friar, that thou hearest of this, unless thou tell me how I may prevent it, if in thy wisdom thou can'test give no help. Friar Lawrence's cell. Producing a dagger, Juliet threatens to kill herself rather than marry Paris, and declares she will comply with any plan of the friar's, however desperate. Do thou but call my resolution wise, and with this knife I'll help it presently. God joined my heart and Romeo's, thou our hands, and here this hand by thee to Romeo's sealed shall be the label to another deed. All my true heart with treacherous revolt turn to another, this shall slay them both. Therefore, out of thy long experienced time, give me some present console, or behind twist my extremes on me. This bloody knife shall play the umpire, arbitrating that which the commission of thy years and art could to no issue of true honour bring. Be not so long to speak, I long to die, if what thou speakest speak not of remedy. Friar Lawrence, howl, daughter, I do spy a kind of hope which craves as desperate an execution as that is desperate which we would prevent, if rather than to marry County Paris thou hast the strength of will to slay thyself, then is it likely thou wilt undertake a thing like death to chide away this shame that copst with death himself to escape from it? And if thou darest, I'll give thee remedy. Juliet, oh, bid me leap rather than marry Paris from off the battlements of any tower, or walk in thievish ways, or bid me lurk where serpents are, chain me with roaring bears, or hide me nightly in a charnel house, covered quite with dead man's rattling bones, with reeky shanks and yellow chapless skulls, or bid me go into a new made grave, and hide me with a dead man in his shroud. Things that to hear them told have made me tremble, and I will do it without fear or doubt, to live an unstained wife to my sweet loved Friar Lawrence. Hold then, go home, be merry, give consent to marry Paris. Wednesday is tomorrow. Friar explains his plan. Juliet is to drink a potion which will cause her to seem dead. Romeo will be notified of the plan by letter, and after Juliet is laid in the Capulet tomb, he will return secretly, and they will escape to Manta together. Tomorrow night, look that thou lie alone. Let not the nurse lie with thee in thy chamber. Take thou this vial, being then in bed, and this distilled liquor drink thou off, when presently through all thy veins shall run and a cold and drowsy humour, for no pulse shall keep his native progress, but sir sees no warmth, no breath shall testify thou livest. The roses in thy lips and cheek shall fade to any ashes. Thy eyes' windows fall like death when he shuts up the day of life. Each part deprived of supple government shall stiff and stark and cold appear like death, and in this borrowed likeness of shrunk death thou shalt continue 2 and 40 hours, and then awake as from a pleasant sleep. Now when the bridegroom in the morning comes to rouse thee from thy bed, there art thou dead. Then, as the manner of our country is, in thy best robes uncovered on the bier, thou shalt be borne to that same ancient vault where all the kindred of the Capulets lie. In the meantime, against thou shalt awake, shall Romeo by letters know our drift, and hither shall he come, and he and I will watch thy waking, and that very night shall Romeo bear thee hence to Manto, and this shall free thee from this present shame, if no inconstant toy nor womanish fear abate thy valour in the acting it. Juliet, give me, O tell not me of fear. Friar Lawrence, hold, get you gone, be strong and prosperous. In this resolve I'll send a friar with speed to Manto with my letters to thy lord. Juliet, love, give me strength, and strength shall help afford. Farewell, dear father. Excellent.